Hey there, it's David H. Lawrence, the 17th, and you know as well as I do that a lot of what we do in this business, in performing, in acting, in voiceover, etc., is unknown and really unpredictable. You have no way of knowing which way a casting team is going to go with a project. You have no way of knowing whether your voice is right for a project or your face and stature. I mean, you can't tell. You can't predict things. There are lots of things you can do instead of being a performer that are a lot surer of a bet, but what we've chosen to do isn't one of them. And so what you need to do to create a safe place for yourself, the ability that you need to self-improve, an environment where you can slowly iterate the good things in and the bad things out, you really have to create a commitment for yourself. And this commitment can take some doing because, again, you have this uncertainty. How am I going to pay the bills? Am I good enough? Am I a fraud? All of these things that we've talked about in other videos. But if you do this one thing, just do this for yourself. And it is a decision. Nothing you have to go out and buy, nothing you have to create, nothing you have to be really good at. It's just a decision that you make for yourself. And that decision is, I'm going to create a safe place to fall. Now, what I mean by that is to have the attitude when you do your work that there's going to be failure. There's going to be times when you succeed, and there's going to be times when you come up short. And those times when you come up short can be really, really devastating to your psyche. But if you have the attitude, if you created for yourself this safe place to fall, this safe place to create mistakes, this safe place to fail, and to learn from that, that all of a sudden creates this comfort zone that makes it easier for you to say, okay, I failed, but here's what I did wrong, and here's what I've learned from that. It's a twofold thing, actually, when you create this safe place to fall or a safe place to fail. And that is that instead of berating yourself for failure, oh my God, I suck, I'm horrible, I'm awful, I'm not good enough, nobody wants me, I'll never work again, I'll never book another thing. Instead of doing that, instead of talking down yourself, instead of talking down to yourself, and instead of talking yourself down, talk yourself up. Hey, I gave it a shot, didn't work, came up short, couldn't get the job done, how come? And then take a look at those things and learn from those things. And equally important is something, I've heard this advice a million times from a million different places, but they forget this other part of it. And I find myself talking to my clients about it all the time. Yeah, give yourself this ability to say, okay, I didn't do it, let's figure out why. That's great. But when you do it, don't minimize your success. Please, if you listen to nothing else from this video, listen to this. When you do things right, when you succeed, take a moment, celebrate, rub your hands together and go, I did that, that's great, it feels so good. Don't let those things become a product of chance. Don't give your success away to somebody else. Oh, the casting director couldn't find anybody else to get this done. I would say also, don't give your power away to another entity. You're doing this. It's not your agent. They may have helped you get the opportunity, but you did it. It's not your teacher or your coach, certainly not me, if you're one of my clients and students. It's you. It is you. You did this. You prepared for it. You were ready. You succeeded. Celebrate that. Don't minimize it ever. Don't be self-deprecating about your excellence. When you nail something, when you do really well at something, I want you to take a moment and really understand that's the goal. Don't become that person that doubts that they're able to succeed. Don't become that person that when they do succeed, they go, oh, well, that was a fluke. That was somebody made a really bad mistake. Now, you can joke about it if you want to. But I really want you to understand, not talking down to yourself when you fail, and not being self-deprecating, truly self-deprecating, when you succeed. Those two things help to create that safe place to fall. so that you know what it feels like to be able to succeed at something, and so you know what it feels like to fail and learn from those failures. Does that make sense to you? Do you find yourself doing this? Do you find yourself succeeding and then going, oh God, I'm so fucked up? Don't do that. Enjoy it. That's the point. That's the joy, right? Why would you minimize that? It's not going to make it less likely that you'll succeed in the future. It's not going to make it more likely that you'll fail if you enjoy yourself. Please create that safe place to fail. And in doing so, don't talk down to yourself when you fail. And don't forget to celebrate when you succeed. Tell me what you think about that. Tell me, is that going to be hard for you to do because you've trained yourself to be that odd gee shucks kicking your instep? Yeah, well, you know, I've been fortunate. No, enjoy it. Tell me in the comments below what you think of this, because this is a big thing for some people to get over, because we've been told so many times in our lives just how awful we are and how we'll never make it. And why did you pick this for your business? You could have been an accountant. You know what I'm saying? Tell me in the comments below. And do so over at viotogogo.com. That's where the conversation is sane and moderated. Just below this video, you'll find a little link for you to subscribe so that you know when these videos are coming out. And also, if you want to see the very latest video that I've done, go ahead and click on that frame there and YouTube will play it for you. I'm David H. Lawrence, the 17th. I thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you tomorrow.